everyone, I'm Roxy and today I wanted to share with you some inspiration on how to get your dream board started for the new year. So I'm a huge believer in dream boards or vision boards or whatever you want to call it because I truly believe that we have the magic inside of us and the ability for us to create and truly live our best life and our dream life. I've already set up my dream board and I'm going to share with you some tips on how easy it is to create your own and why you should create your own. I feel like if you really take some time to create your dream board, it can really set the tone for the rest of the year. So these images on your dream board will represent what you want to do, who you want to be, the kind of life that you want to have. We basically have the ability to attract anything that we give attention to, whether it be positive or negative. So by seeing your dream board every single time you open your planner, it basically is a reminder to yourself that this is what you want in your life and this is what you're attracting in your life for the new year. So here are some easy tips on how you can create your perfect dream board. First thing that I love doing is having a theme. I love the idea of having a theme. I feel like if once you have a color scheme, once you have a concept that you like, it makes it really easy. So these are some different spreads that I did to kind of give you an idea of how beautifully a theme works when you're planning for your dream board. So I did some yellow tones, blues, greens, I did a galaxy spread. All these are just ideas to get you really excited to show you how you can really create a beautiful dream board. So once you have an idea of what you want your theme to be, now it's time to start collecting pictures and stickers. So my favorite place to be is Pinterest. You basically just type in anything that you want and you can even narrow it down by the color scheme of your dream board to make it so much easier. Then I basically drag all of the images onto my computer and then I just print all of them and stick them into my planner. And I love this part. It's kind of like a scrapbooking theme. And this is really inexpensive to do. Even if you don't have access to a printer, you can cut out things from magazines and just keep it within that color scheme and theme that you like. I really love adding in quotes. I feel like if this is something that is also a very good visual reminder, and every time you see it, you kind of reiterate it in your mind and it stops to give you that little bit of inspiration that you may need. So once you have your color scheme, your theme, you've collected all of your pictures, you've collected all of your quotes, you stuck them into your planner, you can be really creative and add things like dried flowers. You can do so many creative things to your dream board. So every time you open it, you get so happy and so inspired. And just remind yourself that you have the ability to truly create your dream life. I hope you enjoyed these tips and that it inspired you to get working on your dream board for the new year. If you want more planner tips and inspiration like this, don't forget to hit that follow button. We have so many exciting things coming this year that we cannot wait to share. So thank you for watching and have a happy new year. Bye.